is about to grow.
Season we celebrate the birth of Christ, but he came here headed to the cross. Amen. And I'm glad that he went. Do what now? All right, junior church to stay up here till after they sing this morning. Woman, don't disrupt me anymore during the middle. I'm just kidding. Amen. Y'all know we got a great relationship, right? Amen. Junior church, stay up here until after they sing. They're going to sing for us here in a few minutes this morning. But listen, while they're coming down this morning, choir, so you don't get so far away. While they're coming down, let's all stand, and everybody that can and will, let's come get around the altar this morning and have a word of prayer. There's a lot of prayer requests out there. You may have a lot on your heart, but let's just come get around the altar. You can pray for yours, pray for those that you don't know about this morning, pray for the lost. There's several children in the hospital we know about that need prayer today. Please pray for them. Well, I don't know their names, preacher. Just ask God who they are and just pray for them this morning. Let's pray for our service today. Pray for those that are in need at this time of the year, and pray that God will just bless and lift up. Send the rain on this place this morning while we're in here today. But let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, again, we love you. And God, what an honor, what a privilege it is, Lord, to be back in the house again today. God, thank you, Lord, for the songs that have been sung this morning. And Lord, we do realize and understand, God, we believe, Lord, that even at this season, Lord, it's all about the cross. Lord, you came with the cross in mind, and God, we thank you for that, for dying for an old wretched sinner like me. God, that you could save the world, Lord, we thank you for that. And Father, we just thank you, Lord, for the season that we get to celebrate, Lord, this time. And God, I know that in the Christian's heart and in the Christian's mind, Lord, it's a season that we celebrate every day of our life. But God, what a time of the year that we get to come together and decorate, Lord, for you, and God, announce your birth, and Lord, how you came here to this earth to die for us. And Father, I pray, Lord, you do it. Help us to do that with unction and power. And God, we'd do it rejoicing in our heart and mind, knowing that it's real. And God, for whatever prayer request is around the altar today, God, would you meet them in a special way? Lord, meet the needs of the homes today, and God, the hearts today, and meet the needs of every child today. And Lord, I pray you meet the needs of every husband and wife, and God, every church and every pastor and every leader and every choir today, every choir member. God, would you meet their very needs? Lord, it's not about our wants. It's not about the gifts, Lord, at this time of the year. But God, help us, Lord, to be the gift to someone else, Lord, as you were to I. And Father, answer the prayer request, Lord, around the altar of the day. Bless the children that we're talking about, Lord, in this place today. The little child that's been burned, Lord, the little Tony Hooper. Father, would you bless him and bless that family. God, we hold him up to you. Little Jamari. God, that we'd met the family of this week, Lord, there in the hospital in ICU. Father, would you bless them? And Father, we hold them up to you and all the kids, Lord, that they're surrounded by today. Father, help them and bless them. And God, then others, Lord, with people that are going through trying times and families that are going through trying times. And Father, would you bless Greg today, Lord, there in the hospital, Lord, right now, and touch him and God, lift him up. And Lord, help the doctors, Lord, to know, Lord, what the extent of it is, and help him, Lord, to get through, and help his parents, Lord, today. And Father, help us, Lord, to look to you for all leadership and guidance. And Lord, bless Brad and Destiny, Lord, Deborah and Sherwin, the birth of the new baby. Father, bless them and bless the child. And God, we'll thank you, Lord, for what you're going to do there. And Lord, those that are in this place this morning that may be hurting, God, for different reasons. They've gone through different things in life. And God, there's been tragedies and Lord, loss of loved ones. Lord, would you bless them and strengthen them? And God, just help them, Lord, to pull through and come out brighter on the other side. Help me to be a better pastor and a better preacher and a better servant. God, have a more willing heart, be a better leader, Lord, in this church. And God, use us, Lord, for your glory. Use this church, God, that it would magnify you every phase of the service today. God, we ask for unction this morning to bless the songs and, Lord, bless the preaching of the word. And God, would you rain upon us, Lord, today, the good Holy Spirit of God. Save that soul that may be near as hell this morning. Lord, draw them to you that may be saved before it's eternally too late. God, save those today that, Lord, thinks they're saved. And God, they've been playing church, Lord, all these years. God, I pray the Holy Spirit of God would touch them and prick them this morning and draw them to an old-fashioned altar, Lord. They may get it right before it's eternally too late. Father, we love you. We thank you, God, for what you've done for us through the Sunday school hour. And Lord, through the singing already, bless our time together from here on out. And God, we'll praise you for it on credit. We ask all these things in Christ's wonderful name. Amen. 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 Michael, come on. Lead us in a song this morning. Take an offering this morning.
All right, let's get our ushers to come up this morning if they would. As they come in this morning, you'll be finding 371, old little town of Bethlehem. We're going to sing. Let's all stand this morning. Bro Chris, we take you to the Lord in prayer and bless our offering for us this morning.
Father, we thank you for this opportunity to give back to you.
Yes, God.
Lord, you gave all to us. You gave us everything.
Yes.
And so little in return for us. Lord, this is our opportunity to be blessed by you and following your commands. Father, just ask to be with us and bless us. Bless this service today. Amen.
Amen. 371, old little town of Bethlehem.
Yeah.
this morning. Can I just be perfectly honest with you this morning? I said around here on Wednesday night that most of the church cannot handle the truth. Amen? But can I be perfectly honest with you this morning? Y'all were dragging. We got to sing today. Amen? I need you to get your books when we sing. I need you to open up and rejoice in the Lord. It is the day we celebrate the birth of our Lord and say, I understand it's Sunday a couple of days before he gets there, but this is our church service for it, amen? And you're kind of dragging this morning. If you don't like that, cheer up. I won't say that, amen? And so I pray that we'll cheer up. Listen, we're going to sing some during the service this morning, so you go ahead and get ready right now. Get your books out. When I say get your books, if you don't know the song, get them out, because we're going to sing some during the service this morning, rejoice in the Lord. I'm going off the cuff this morning to do something totally different from what I've been doing around here, so y'all better, you better wake up now, and we're going to have a good time with the Lord here in just a little while. But I appreciate the choir song this morning. I appreciate the singing already today. Didn't all that red look beautiful up there today? Just listen, it represents Christmas and what it is, and I appreciate that and what they're doing today. So just remember, let me just say this, couple announcements. We will not have a service here tonight. There's a lot of people away from us today. There's a lot of people going to be away from us tonight. A lot of people having suppers and dinners and meeting with family and all those kind of things and the giving of gifts. But I want you to know something. Jane and I are going to be here this afternoon in prayer, okay? I'm going to open the doors at 5:30, and they will be open until 7 o'clock this afternoon if you want to come and pray for the Christmas holidays. Jane and I are going to be here early. We're going to be here praying this afternoon, but we're not going to have a service. But if you have time and want to come and get around the altar and pray, we'll pray with you. I don't know if we'll be here the whole time, but we'll be here some of that time. And we're going to be here praying for the Christmas holidays, for the Christmas service, and praying for you, praying for our family and your families this afternoon. So if you want to come and be a part of the prayer service this afternoon, you please come. I know there's a lot of events scheduled for different things for the day, and so that's okay. Spend time with your family. Have a good time, Lord, but don't forget the reason for the season while we're having a good time. Amen? And so we will be here this afternoon doing that. Let me just mention this. I mentioned my prayer. Brad and Destiny had their little boy yesterday, 9 pound, 1 ounce. Am I right about that? 9 pound, 1 ounce yesterday. So Yance is another great-grandfather now. Amen? So we praise the Lord for that. Everything's healthy and everything is good there. Continue to pray for them. And then coming up after the first year, there's going to be a lot of upcoming events. You said, Preacher, we just got through a lot of events. Trust me, when the list comes out the first of the year, it's going to be big, okay? But we've got a lot of upcoming events next year already for different things. For the revival meeting, we're going to start special prayer meetings for that. Several meetings coming up for different things. And so you pray much for those things that will be coming up next year. And already just lay yourself aside and say, listen, I'm going to serve God next year. And we're going to do all that we can to be in the house of the Lord. And so you pray much about that, if you would, okay? Anything else today as far as announcements? Anything at all? All right, no service tonight, but we'll be here at 5:30. The doors will be open from 5:30 to 7, and we'll be here praying some during that time. And if you want to come, you can come and be with us. Now, I'm going to keep you until 4 o'clock this afternoon since I'm not preaching tonight, just so you know. I see them looks on your faces. Forget about it. And I'm just. I told you couldn't handle the truth, amen? But hey, let me just say this. Wednesday night, if you've not been coming on Wednesday night, I've been more, I don't know why, but seemingly I've been more excited about the Wednesday night service lately than I have the Sunday morning service, and that probably shouldn't be true. I'm always excited about every service, but we have enjoyed our Wednesday night service teaching on demon warfare. Some of you could use that. Amen. But we've had a good time teaching on. Some of you look at me like I'm crazy. Amen. You're the crazy one. But we've been teaching on demon warfare, and it grows week after week after week. And I'm telling you, we've had a good time, and I have enjoyed that teaching. We will go back to that again this Wednesday night. We won't finish it up this Wednesday night. I will say that because it's grown again this week. But we have had a good time with it. So you come, and we're going to try to teach you as best we can how to get strong in the Lord so we can fight them off in our life. Amen? And so you pray about that, okay? All right, our kids are going to sing for us this morning. So all of our junior kids are going to sing. Come on up this morning.
Thank you. hopeless world would wait. Sin demanded justice at a price we could not pay. But God displayed his mercy, the greatest gift of love. When we could not reach heaven, heaven came to us. Yes. In Bethlehem, a stable became a throne of grace, as God himself, our Savior, draw near to take our place. His mother smiled in wonder as shepherds stood in awe. The sacrifice of heaven lay sleeping in the straw. Died our death, the precious Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. He made a way in a manger to make a way to the cross.
Thank you.
Tabby and Blake gonna sing one for us. Amen. Thank you, Miss Jennifer Washington. Appreciate that. Amen. Isn't that beautiful? Love those kids up here singing. Blake and Tappa's going to sing one for us today before we get started also.
Beautiful star of Bethlehem, shining afar through shadows dim, giving a light for those who long have gone, and guiding the wise men on their way unto the place where Jesus lay. Oh, beautiful star of Bethlehem, shine on. Oh, beautiful star. Oh, beautiful star of Bethlehem, shine on,
shine on.
Oh, beautiful star, the hope of light, guiding the wise men through the night, over the mountains till the break of dawn, and into the give out a lovely ray. Oh, beautiful star of Bethlehem, shine on. Oh, beautiful star of
Bethlehem,
shine upon us until the glory dawns. Oh, give us a light to light the way unto the land of perfect day. Oh, beautiful star of Bethlehem, shine on,
shine on.
Oh, beautiful star. Oh, beautiful star of Bethlehem, shine on,
shine on.
Amen. Amen. If you would turn your Bibles this morning to the book of Luke, chapter 2. I know I read this last Sunday night, the Christmas story there. Blake read just a few verses of it this morning. During the opening, but I want to take my text from there today and try to preach to you what God's laid upon my heart these last few weeks for this day. And like I said, they're going to hang around up here. We're going to do some things a little different this morning. We're going to rejoice over the birth of the Lord. Amen. Amen. And I want to preach to you today about that perfect gift. I know that most of you have been shopping for weeks now. Some of you have waited till the last minute. Amen. If you was like me, you would anyway. And there's going to be a lot of valuable gifts given. There's going to be a lot of precious gifts unwrapped and those kind of things this Christmas season. But I want to preach to you today about that perfect gift, if I can. And we want to ring in that perfect gift if we can today. So I'm going to read Luke chapter 2. I'm going to read the first 20 verses, and I'm going to preach to you what God just placed upon my heart for you today. Pray it'll be a blessing to you. This morning, the Bible says, and it came to pass in those days that went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, everyone to his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, And they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, may want to underline those words like right there, amen. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen as it was told unto them. I said to you, I want to preach to you on this thought today, the perfect gift. Or we could say the greatest gift ever unwrapped. As I already said, I know that there's going to be a valuable gift, precious gift unwrapped this Christmas season in the next couple of days. There's no question about that. There's going to be gifts that will be unwrapped that will mean a lot to a lot of people. And then there's going to be gifts that's going to be unwrapped. They're going to say, that's another sweater. There's going to be gifts that's going to be unwrapped, and they're going to say, another fruitcake. I don't know about y'all, but I love some fruitcake, amen. Don't send me 100 of them, but I do like them, amen. I will tell you that. There's going to be gifts out there that people are going to rejoice over. There's going to be gifts out there that people are going to be, they're going to look at, and they're going to go about their business and really never pay it in the mind. But listen, most of us have been shopping, most of y'all that shop, let's put it that way. You've been shopping all season or all this Christmas season. You've been shopping for the perfect gift for somebody the whole time. Whether it's a child or whether it's a spouse or whether whoever it is, you've been shopping for that perfect gift. And seemingly you won't rest until you find that perfect gift. I know people out there that, listen, they'll fight you over that perfect gift. They'll get up early and go long days. They'll fight the crowd. Yesterday was called, what they call it, Panic Saturday. Am I right about that? I'd have been in a panic if I'd have had to go out there, amen. And several people around me would have been panicking too, amen. But yesterday was called Panic Saturday. They got the before Christmas holidays, the shopping days. They're going to have the after Christmas shopping days. They done named every day you can name now. And all of those days that are named and all of those things that they do and all of those sales that are going on, they are doing so that you can find the perfect gift for the person you want to find it for. They know that you're out there. They know that you're hunting. And you will go to great lengths to find that gift. You will spend great money to get that perfect gift. I've seen some things that people bought and paid for. You see some things online that I wouldn't give you 2 cents for that people are paying thousands of dollars for because it's got a name on it. I've seen people wait till the last minute for those kind of gifts, and they may have cost $100 at the store, but they're paying $2,000 for it online so they can get it. They are doing all that they can to find that perfect gift. Why? Because come Christmas morning, you want that person to unwrap that perfect gift. You want them to be excited. Amen. I tell you what, if I go spend $2,000 on a gift, I want somebody to be excited. I go spend a couple grand on a gift, and they open and go, whoa, look, that ain't going to be good around my house. Amen. Chances are that'll be the last one to ever get around there. Amen. But listen, I know that we're hunting for that perfect gift. As I got to studying this scripture weeks ago and praying and asking God and looking at the birth of Christ, there will be no gift unwrapped. There will be no gift given. There will be no gift that will be more surprising this Christmas season or more valuable or as needed as the gift that God gave to Mary some 2,000 years ago that she wrapped in swaddling clothes. There's no gift that you can find out there anywhere that would be as important to your life as the gift of Jesus Christ that you and I are accessible to every day of our life. We don't have to fight the crowds to get, trust me, you ain't got to fight the crowds to get to Jesus. There was a time over there in the book of Mark chapter 2 they had to fight the crowds because he was in the house preaching. But this day and time, you don't have to fight the crowds to get to Jesus, amen. Even though he's the most precious gift that you could ever unwrap around your house or in the church at Christmas time, he was the most precious gift that was ever given in life. But I got to thinking, before I unwrapped that gift, listen, to unwrap something means to unveil something or to reveal something. And before I reveal that gift to you today, I wanted to think about this for a little while. I wanted to talk about how he came into the earth and the special birth that it was. You want you to think about this thing. I want you to think about the birth of Christ himself and how it was birthed to the earth. We were back in the hospital yesterday morning, and there with Brad and Destiny and praying with them. And Deborah Sher was excited. Brad and Destiny's excited, nervous, and the people around them, all the families are excited. And these kind of things, you walk in the hospital room, man, it's a nice hospital room. Listen, they got all the comforts you'd ever want nowadays in a hospital room. But I want you to think for just a minute about this birth right here. And I want to share this with you before I share the gift with you. It was a birth. It was birth without any special attendance whatsoever. Wasn't any special attendance there outside of Joseph and Mary and the animals in the stable that day. Amen. It was birthed into the world without any special attendance. It was birthed into the world without any doctors. You ladies, think about that for just a minute, amen. It was birthed into the world without any nurses or any maids around them. It was birthed into the world without a hospital. It came into the world without a nursery. It came into the world without a delivery room. It came into the world without any epidurals. Amen. It came into the world without that. It came into the world without any clean linens. It came in the world without any sterilization. It came into the world without any family present around at the time. He was birthed in the lowliest thing that you could ever be birthed in at that time. But God sent him here as the most precious gift that could ever be unwrapped in this world for you and I. He was the perfect gift. God was sending his best for the devil's worst down here. He was a perfect gift. You could have shopped the world over, and you would have never found a gift as precious as Jesus Christ. Matter of fact, let me say this to you here today before I get started. If you're in this place and you're lost on today, there's never more precious gift than you coming to know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior of your life today. The malls ain't got nothing on that, amen. They ain't got nothing they'd sell you out there that would help you in that. You can buy every book you want to buy, listen to everything you want to listen to, and make yourself happy for a few minutes, but after a while it's going to wear off. But listen, Jesus came to the earth to be the most perfect gift that was ever rendered to mankind down here. God gave his only begotten son to make sure that that would happen. But then I got to thinking about these scriptures right here. I said, God, he was born in a lowly manger. There wasn't any doctors there. There wasn't any nurses there. There wasn't any special attendants there in the stable. There was not a hospital. There was no medicine. He didn't have any clean linens and all these things. There was no sterilization there. All of these things that he didn't have. But according to the Word of God, there were some folks looking on. And I got to thinking about all those that were looking on. And I got to thinking about how special of a birth that it truly was when I looked at all these things. Number one, if we go back up here, to go to verse 9, the Bible says, "And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people." My mind just goes a little crazy every now and then, and I get out there a little bit, and I go off the cuff a little bit, and I begin to look up in heaven, and I got to thinking about those angels looking down at the most glorious gift. Look, you know how it is when you find the most glorious gift you can find? You know how it is when you finally go to the mall and you finally find it, and you look, you almost shout, and you almost sing a song like, "Oh my goodness, I finally found it. I got the perfect one. I got the one I want to give them. I know they're going to be excited about this." Listen, I got to thinking about the angels up there and looking down on this and watching this birth down here and what was going on in glory. I wasn't concerned about what was going on in the stable anymore. I was concerned about what was going on in glory because the most perfect gift could ever be was born on this earth. There may not have been much going on in the stable, but there was a lot going on over there, amen. And so I got to thinking about some songs they could sing today and represent those angels. And I just believe that the angels may have been singing something like this today.
Did you know that your baby boy will one day walk on water?
Oh, all, you got a picture this church.
Mary, did
listen,
you
got to get in glory today.
That's your baby boy will save our sons and daughters.
Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered will soon deliver you.
Did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm a storm with his hand?
Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you've kissed the face of God.
Oh, Mary, did you know?
Hey, you got to think about that from a heavenly perspective today, friend. You got to look down from glory to hear that today.
The blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak, the praises of the Lamb.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nation?
Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? This sleeping child you're holding is the great I Am.
Just stay there as long as you want to. I got to looking at those, that heavenly host the other day, and I got to thinking about those angels, and I thought about that song, and I'm going to tell you what, you got to look at it from a heavenly perspective. When these angels are looking down, listen, they see the most perfect gift that's ever, I got cold chills right here, amen, the most perfect gift that's ever been on this earth, the most perfect gift that could have ever been unwrapped down here. And I believe those angels could have just stood in heaven saying, listen, they think that's a new song down here, amen. I believe that's something they created in heaven over there in glory some 2,000 years ago before any songwriter ever thought about writing anything around here. I believe the angels looked over in the portals of glory, looked down and saw baby Jesus down in a lowly manger and said, ain't nobody around him, but I'm going to tell you what, we about to have ourselves a spell and tell the world who he is in there. And the angels begin to sing. But they ain't the only ones I found over there, amen. They ain't the only ones I found. Hey, the more I read in this thing, I look here in verse 13 and 14. Look here with me if you would. The Bible says, and suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, listen to this, glory to God in the highest and on earth, peace, goodwill toward men. It wasn't just the angel. The Bible said, I believe when the angels got cranked up around there, they looked down and they saw this perfect gift, and they saw the Lamb of God down here in a stable in Bethlehem. I believe the whole choir got cranked up around, got on in glory. And now we're going to get the whole choir involved in this thing. Tab, y'all stand up. I want our whole church to stand up. If you need a songbook, turn to page 408 today. We're going to sing Joy to the World. Listen, this is what it should have sounded like in heaven over there that day when Jesus was born. That night in Bethlehem, this is what it sounded like. Amen. Let's sing like we know he's been born today. Joy to the world. Amen. Amen. Listen, I said the whole heavenly multitude over there. The Bible said that there was a heavenly multitude that started singing. I don't believe it was just a few of them. I believe the angels started singing. All of a sudden, a few of these got cranked up. And the next thing you know, a few of them got cranked up. And I believe the whole host of heaven over there was singing. And we only got a few of you cranked up that time. We're not where we're supposed to be yet glorifying God. We're not where we're supposed to be rejoicing over the birth of you. Listen, you've been running back and forth. You've been excited about that. You've been jumping up and down when you found that perfect gift. I'm giving you the most perfect gift you could ever find today. If there's ever a time rejoicing, we ought to be rejoicing now that we know that the birth has happened here. Let's start back over on that verse again. Hey, the whole host rejoice. Amen. Let's sing. Amen. Everybody. Christ, amen. Some of you shouted in the mall when you found it, and they still know who you are. They got your picture posted on the wall on the camera over there. Amen. You were so excited about it. We're talking about the most perfect gift that was ever given, ever unveiled, that was revealed, ever wrapped on this side of earth. Listen, it's time for you and I to rejoice over the birth of Christ. Said, Brother Mike, I just don't do that. Shut up, please. I heard you at the ball game, amen. Let's rejoice over the Savior today. Let's sing it again. Michael, let's go again. Joy to the world. Sing, church. Here we go. Now we're going.
Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. And in nature's
name. Can you imagine sweet words like that coming down to Mary while she's lying there in the stable and lying out on whatever she was lying on there, the baby just been born, and here this angel coming down there, they're singing out her beautiful words like that. And can you imagine when the host of angels showed up and the whole choir
this is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. I have sent him into the world, not to condemn the world, but that the world might be through him saved. Hear ye him and rejoice that a Savior has been born.
Christ the King, the help of all who seek him, the hope of all who find, none other is so loving, so good.
Hey!
He lives, Christ Jesus lives today. He walks with me and talks with me along this narrow way. He lives, salvation to impart.
Here we go!
You ask me how I know he lives. He lives within my heart.
Hang around for just a minute, Michael. I don't believe we're done with that. Be seated for just a minute. Listen, they're not the only ones there. Amen. I got to thinking about this right here too. while I was thinking about it, I think about the angels, and I think about that heavenly host up there, and I think about God the Father, and I think about listening to what he said about the son there. And then I got to thinking about this right here. I believe the Holy Spirit of God looked on. I really do. Listen, the Bible says that it's the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, and these three are one. The Bible says they all bear record in heaven together. I believe when he looked down at the Lord Jesus Christ himself, his only begotten son, his beloved son, his precious son. I said it last week. Everything about him was good. His prized son, according to what commentaries would say. That everything about him pointed to perfectness, and everything about him pointed to peace. And he sent him down, and all those looking on. And then here's the Holy Spirit of God looking on. Knowing that he was going to follow him. See, Jesus wasn't the only one came down. Woo! But Mark, I got thinking about this. Kind of got excited, to be honest with you. I'm glad that Jesus came, amen. I'm glad that he died. I'm thankful that he died to save a wretched old soul like me. But the Bible says that when he left, that he had sent another comforter, amen. That another comforter would come. And that it would take that comforter, preacher, to deal with the hearts of mankind. Down here, that man can be redeemed from his wretched sin. On his side down here is the Holy Spirit of God looking down, thinking, oh God, this is good. God, I've been here with you all these years. I've heard the angels sing. I've heard the choir sing. God, I've heard about your son down there. He's given his life for the world. But God, I'm going to have to go down, and I'm going to have to knock on the hearts of the people when I get down there. I know that he's going to hang on the cross. I know the third day he's going to bury him again. And the third day he's going to rise. And I know he's coming back. But I know when he comes back, you're going to send me down there, Father, and I want to be prepared when I go. I believe that Holy Spirit would sing something like this. Chapter.
Oh, come,
he's standing in glory. He's looking down at the sun.
Joyful and triumphant.
He's looking at the manger. He's in glory.
Come,
here's what he's saying. Here's what he's saying. Come, all ye faithful, amen.
Come,
oh my goodness,
and behold him.
Oh, God, help.
Born the King of angels. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
Sing that last verse. Sing that last verse. Amen. Listen, I don't believe he's done yet. I want to sing it. I got thinking about, listen, I appreciate the Holy Spirit of God. The Bible says without the Spirit of God drawing us, we're not getting it. Amen. That's the Holy Spirit of God. Quit singing like
sing choirs of angels singing exultation. Oh, come ye, oh, come ye to Bethlehem.
Hey, Bethlehem, the house of bread. He said, oh, come.
Come and behold him, born the kings of angels. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
Sing it. Tab, oh, come, let us adore him.
Oh, come, let us
I'm talking about worshiping the Holy God today.
Oh,
I'm talking about
let
the most perfect gift that ever come to glory.
Him.
I'm talking about adoring the Holy God, the Father, and the Son. I will please the Lord today. Friend, it's time you and I
Christ
love to worship him.
Christ the Lord.
And forget about the gifts out there. He
oh,
is the greatest
come,
gift.
Let us adore
on
him.
This side of
oh,
here.
Come, let us adore him.
Hey.
Oh, come.
Thinking about true worship, one where we just give it all to him, amen, where we go sprawl out at his feet, where we look over the portals of glory. And I'm telling you, listen, you're going to have to get in glory to find this right here, and you're going to have to get in the Holy Spirit of God to find this. You ain't going to find it in the world, and you ain't going to find it in yourself. You ain't going to find it in your pride. You're going to have to swallow something in your life, and you're going to have to understand he's a holy God, and he's adorable, and he's worth worshiping today. And you're going to have to understand he's the most perfect gift that was ever given. Listen, my kids were gifts to me. My grandbabies were gifts to me. My wife's been a gift to me for 36 years, but ain't nothing in my life ever stirred my soul the way that that adorable Son of Jesus Christ, when he sent him down here to die for us. And I got to thinking about that Holy Spirit the other day, and he said, oh, God, I just want to adore him. I got to follow him. He's coming back, and I got to follow him. Listen, he's got to remain here until God calls us home. Yeah. We'll take some time to adore him this Christmas. Yeah. We'll take some time just to worship him. We'll get up in the portals of glory and just close our eyes the other day. Back in my seat, and I just got glory. I've been talking to Jane about this message several days this week. I wouldn't tell her everything about it, because I don't know, most times don't disperse my message, because I don't want no negative from anybody. Not that she'd be negative, but I don't want her, because there's time to time I told about message. She said, Daddy, you might not ought to do that. You ought to think about that. I have thought about it, me and God both. Amen. But Brother Mike, I think it's time we ought to just adore him. I think the world ought to know it. Listen. That ain't all that happened. That's just about part of the story. That's just what was going on in glory. Amen. And if we switch gears real quick, we find out what was going on the earth. Amen. Because the Bible says that God unwrapped him. Well, I said that word unwrapped means reveals him or unveils him to the people on earth. Amen. So all I've shown you so far, which is good, and we can stop right there and say it's been good to be in the house of God and go to the house as far as I'm concerned. I'd like to end on a good worship note, amen? I'd like to end on a good note, adoring our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and go on to the house and just have myself a blast the rest of the day, amen? It'd be good. But it don't end right there. He was birthed on this earth, and then God began to reveal him to people on earth. He began to reveal him to some people searching for him, some people that was looking for him, some people that had heard about his birth, some people that had in their mind that, wait a minute, they said a Savior was going to be born, and I need to be looking for something. I don't want to miss it. Any of you just been looking for something you don't want to miss? Hey, man, most of you have been looking for a sale the last 2 weeks. on a computer every 5 minutes. You're punching. I don't want to miss that. I don't want to miss that. I got to have that gift. I got to have that gift right there. Amen. Listen, if I had to do all that, my kids, my wife never get it. My wife don't get anything anyway. Amen. But when you got everything, you don't need anything. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. But listen, let me give you several things. Look here with me, verse 17. He began to unwrap this gift, unveil this gift, reveal this gift to the world. Look what he says. The Bible says that the shepherds here, you got to remember, they were in the field watching flock, and the angels came. And the shepherds are going, wait a minute, hold on. What's all that singing about? What's all that going on over there? What's all that beautiful music about? What's that noise from above? It sounds like the Father has said something about his Son over there. And the Bible says here that they start out to Bethlehem and get themselves into Bethlehem. They say, hey, we have got to go find what they're talking about here. We need to see this Lord Jesus Christ. And the Bible says in verse 17, and when they had seen it, listen what they did. I love this part right here. Listen, you ought to think about this if you're a Christian today. Matter of fact, everywhere I read in God's Word, I find this right here. Most time for the Christians, amen. It says, when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. In other words, they went out and started to announce the birth of Jesus Christ. Somebody said the other day, and I'm not a big football fan. I watch a little bit here and there when I get time. I watch a little bit of racing. When I get time, I'm just still a redneck at heart. I could give a flip less about watching a basketball game, to be honest with you. I'm just not a big basketball fan. If you are, that's okay. Amen. But I watch a little bit here and there. And somebody said the other day about Tim Tebow. Amen. I like Tim Tebow. Amen. I like his stand for Christ. One of them rascals said the other day, he just needs to cool it. You need to shut up.
Right.
Amen. What you need to do is go try to get to him, let two or three of them linebackers take your head off. Amen. You shut up about Christianity. Amen. I'm glad he's spreading the good news.
Amen.
The Bible says when the shepherds saw it, when they knew it for themselves, they began to go abroad and announce the birth of Jesus Christ. Hey, there's a Savior that's been born.
Yeah.
They were excited about it. They were ecstatic about what was taking place. They began to go tell others. The Bible says they praised him and they shouted for joy. Let me tell you something today, Christian. It's time we stop being dead about the birth of Christ. Somebody said recently, they want to make our Christmas parade uptown in Roxburgh now. They want to make it a holiday parade. You know what I told the wrestlers? Go get you a day and make you a parade.
That's right.
If I don't want to attend yours, I won't attend it.
That's right.
And if you don't want to attend ours, don't attend it. Stay at the house. Go get your day. Go get it approved and go get you a parade and get all your crowd to come. Have your set time. You ain't going to bother me because if I don't want to be there, I ain't going to be there. You don't like the name of Christ and you don't like Christmas and you don't like what's going on and you don't like us shouting that name, shut up and stay at the house. We're going to announce the birth of Christ. That's what it's about. We're to be shepherds for Christ.
Yeah.
According to the Word of God. We're to be shepherds. We're to be servants.
Yeah.
And if there's one thing we ought to be doing is announcing the birth of Christ at this
Amen.
Time of year, all year long. Why do you do all that, Brother Mike? Because he died for me.
Right.
Because he came to this earth for me. And we just announced, why do you praise him like that? You ought to just, you just need to calm down. Calm down for what? I know some people I like to tell calm down. Amen. I like to get up in one of these basketball arenas, football arenas, some of these arenas somewhere, and all the crowd cheer because somebody put a little round basketball in a little round hole. And everybody goes crazy. And you won't believe who done it. I don't care a flip who done it. I like to get in the middle of the crowd, give me a microphone, and put me in the middle of the floor. I promise you I'd get some attention. They wouldn't be looking at the basketball at that time. They may drag me out real soon, but they wouldn't be looking at the basketball at that time. Amen. I'd praise him. Amen. I'd shout for joy for him. It's time you and I shouted the joy. Amen. A Savior has been born.
Yes.
That's what we celebrate at this time of year. They went about telling others. Not only that, I got to think about this. I don't say it here in the book of Luke, but I go to Matthew, and I'm not going to turn over Matthew chapter 2 and verses 10 through 11. It talks about the wise men. And it talks about how they saw the star from afar, and they started to follow that star, and they followed it to Bethlehem. And when they got there and they saw the baby Jesus, the Bible says they came to where he was. Can I say something to you today? It'd be nice for the church to get where Jesus is at. That's too many playgrounds going on in the church. And that's too many people want to be pleased and tickled and tickled around the ear and feel good. When I feel good today.
Amen.
Amen. I feel good when they're talking about salvation. Amen. That crowd don't like is just convicted when they talk about it. Amen. So they say that's not the place. Where is the place for it? Without the gospel, there's no remission of sin. Amen. We've got to have the gospel. But the wise men, the Bible said they came to where he was. It also said this about him. It seemed like me. There's a pattern here when I look at this. You know what they did? They rejoiced.
Amen.
They just started to rejoice. When they saw the baby Jesus, they just started to rejoice. I want to say this, but I don't want to get ahead of myself. You know why a lot of Christians are not rejoicing today? They ain't seen him. They ain't seen him well enough yet. They ain't seen him well enough to rejoice and think that he died for me. The Bible says that the wise men rejoiced. They came to where he was. It also says this about them, that they worshiped. The Bible says they worshiped. The Bible says when they came to where he was, they worshiped. When they finally saw him, they worshiped. Hey, let me just cross some lines right here while I'm here. Amen. I won't get all the way down on the floor so I don't get hurt down here. But let me just cross some lines right here. The Bible says they gave all when they saw him. They gave up all their treasures. They didn't. They what they had, they gave to him with the frankincense and myrrh and all the gifts. They just gave it all to him. They didn't stinge back and trying to find that perfect gift for somebody else. They bought it all to the Lord. Can I say this to you tonight, today, Christian? I'll cross the line right here. I know. You're giving more to your kids and more to your people around you than you are to Christ. There's a problem with the Christian there somewhere. Amen. This is not about your child. It's not their birthday. This is not about your wife or your husband or your mama or your daddy or your friends or your church people or your pastor. It's not about us. It's about him. It'd take a very wise man. Listen. Since we're talking about wise men, Brock, it'd take a very wise man to give it all to Jesus. It'd take a very wise man to give all the gifts to Jesus. Take a very wise person, amen? But we're still looking for that perfect gift, amen? He's already come to the earth. The wise men came. They gave of all their treasures. They gave of everything that they had. I got to thinking about this one right here. John the Baptist. The Bible says, according to the Word of God, that God revealed him to John the Baptist. Anybody know what John the Baptist said when he saw Jesus for the first time? Behold, the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the world. The first time John ever saw him, John looked at him when he was standing in the river and said, behold, the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the world. You know what John saw him as? John saw him as the atonement for sin in his life. He's the only atonement there is. He's the only thing that can wash away one sin in my life and your life. He's the only thing that can save the world from sin. And when John saw him, wouldn't it be good today when Christians saw him? I mean, when we really got a hold to him and God revealed it to us through the Spirit of God, if we just stood up and said, behold, the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the world. Or behold, the Lamb of God that taketh away my sin. He came just for me.
Yeah. Glory. Glory.
That my sin could be redeemed. What would it be like today if a church really saw him? And he was really revealed to us in the fashion of Christ, the atonement for sin, the one that takes away the sin of the world.
Yes.
Oh, I can only imagine what the church would do. I go back and I get to thinking about those in heaven that saw him born, the angels, Mary, I'm going to tell you something about that little boy that was just born down there. I need to sing you a sweet song about him. All of a sudden, all those heavenly hosts said, God, I knew you was going to do it. You told us you, from the port of the time, God, you said you was going to send him. Look, look, let's sing for him. Let's rejoice over him. Father speaks down and said, my beloved son in whom I'm well pleased. He said, I didn't send him the word to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Yeah. Hear ye him. The Holy Spirit looking down again. There he is. He's going to pave the way. Good gracious of life. He's going to pave the way, and I'm going right behind him. Because once he's out of here, those people are going to need somebody. Once he's out of here, those people are going to need somebody. They're going to need somebody of Nanny Miss Carla to tap on them. They're going to need somebody every now and then to meet with them in the midnight hour.
Amen.
They're going to need somebody every now and then when they're broken and laying up in a hospital bed or laying in a jail cell. And there's some laying there today also. They're going to need somebody. And I got to be the one to go. And through all of that, Jesus said, God said, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to send you down there. And through you, I'm going to reveal him to every person that will receive him. I'm going to unwrap him through you. Can I say this again today? If the Holy Spirit of God has never dealt with you, Jesus has never been unwrapped to you. He's never been revealed to you. Amen. He must be revealed to you through the Holy Spirit of God. I told him Wednesday night. I don't want to get off track here, but this may help you. I told him Wednesday night. I was dealing with a young man a couple of weeks ago. There's a lot more of you here today, and you probably need to hear this. A couple of weeks ago, I was dealing with a young man. And Brother Cruz, he's from Puerto Rico. His family's from Puerto Rico. And this young man was, I got to talk to him about the Lord and got to talk to him about church. And here's what he told me about the church. I told him this Wednesday night. Here's what he told me. He said, I want to go into a church where everybody can have their own opinion about the gospel. That's what he told me. I was kidding the other night. I said, basically, you can come to that church. And most people do. Amen. I know a lot of people got their own opinion because they don't pay no attention to me. That's exactly right. Listen to me. If they paid attention to me, some of them would change.
Amen.
You trying to change? No, I'm not trying to change. But the Holy Spirit of God will. Amen. And this is what I told him. I want you to find your church. And I said, you can come to that church and you'll find this. But if you'll find your church with a man of God that'll pray and preach and discern the word of God and preach to you, and the Holy Spirit of God get in that place, I said, he'll reveal the same thing to you that he reveals to that man of God. There's only one interpretation of the Word of God. It's not mine. It's the Spirit of God. But you know what the average church member wants today? They want to do it themselves. They want their own interpretation. Well, I just don't believe the Bible says that. How would you know if you ain't read it? How would you know if you hadn't begged for the Spirit of God to deal with you over it? How would you know if you've not prayed over it, you've not discerned it, you've not prayed God to give you the power and the understanding of the Word of God about what that means in your life? You know why so many people are running rampant and still trying to find the perfect gift, and they're trying to find the perfect world, and they're still trying to find something to make them happy? Because they will not listen to the Spirit of God. He came. He knew Jesus was leaving and going back. And he came to deal with mankind down here on this earth.
Right.
To give us life. And unless he reveals God to us, unless he reveals the Son to us, we will be lost and headed for a devil's hell, according to the Word of God. It is not your opinion. It is not my opinion. Well, preacher, I just can't believe what you're saying. Why don't you read the Word of God and see if it's there? I mean, the Bible says where two or three agree on me, where two would agree, amen. Why don't you read the Word of God and see if that's what it says? If that's what it says and that's what I'm saying, then why don't you do it? Oh, it's getting serious. Now, we enjoyed it a while ago when we was adoring. But we don't like it when the truth is being told. We just want to worship Him. Yeah, oh, that's good. But you cannot truly worship something you don't know. You can't worship Him if you do not know Him in spirit and truth. You cannot raise your arms in worship. You cannot shout the victory. You cannot go crazy over the greatest gift that was ever given. You will not be able to do that because you're in a battle with the flesh, and it will not allow you to do that.
Exactly. Amen.
I've been in situations before. Been in great service. And preacher, I just want to shout. It's quiet. Thank God I'm tied up here. If somebody would just shout, if somebody would just sneeze, I'd call it a shout, and I'd shout. If I could see any sign whatsoever, and I've seen time to God deal with me and the Holy Spirit of God, they said, why don't you start it? Thank God all these people are in here. You know how many people would drop dead if I jumped up in the middle of this place and shouted, they'd fall over in the pew and go, somebody get him out of here. It's tough to be bound up with that. But once He's ever revealed to you in the right fashion, I really don't care who's around. I tell people this all the time. Y'all ever had anybody disagree with you? I have a lot of them. And probably people tell me that, well, that's fine. You don't change nothing I do. You don't dictate.
He's still God whether you like
him or not. Still God whether you like me or not. He's still God whether you like the Bible or not. Amen. Why? Because the Holy Spirit of God said He was. Amen. He revealed Himself to me some 35 years ago. Let me just tell this and I'm going to shut up and quit. We're going to go back and sing that song, Adore Him, in just a minute. We're going to end on that note in just a minute. 35 years ago, October 22nd, I've told this before, and some of you know it. Sitting in my living room, 10 o'clock at night, God revealed Himself to me. He revealed the Son of God. How? Through the Holy Spirit of God. I wasn't in church.
I wasn't reading the Bible.
God revealed Him to me. Amen. What happened, Preacher Mike? We called a preacher. Amen. The preacher came over, took his Bible, showed me what I must do to be saved, walked me through the plan of salvation. I called the Lord Jesus Christ to save me. What have you been doing since then, telling people about Him?
Amen.
Yeah.
What have you been doing since then, praising Him? What have you been doing since then? Been in church ever since then. Been faithful in church. Been in Sunday school. Been in Wednesday night Bible study. Been in church. Listen, and then God led me to the pulpit to preach. What have you been doing since then? Just worshiping Him.
Yes.
Amen.
Why?
Amen.
He's the greatest gift
that's
ever been unwrapped to me.
Amen.
My wife and I don't do gifts, and y'all know that. Every now and then I'll surprise her and make her mad and get her a gift. Amen. She gets mad, but making up is fun. Amen. But we don't even do gifts. It's not about a gift. It's about Him.
Amen.
I'll ask you a question today just before they sing. If you're in this place today and you can't worship God and you can't adore Him through this, it's not God. The line is still open. The road's still wide open for you to come where you can worship and adore Him. But let me ask you something today. Has that gift ever been truly revealed to you? Whether you know that you know Him as Lord and Savior of your life, and He's the greatest gift that's ever been revealed to you in your life. Somebody's going to get up tomorrow. I mean, Tuesday morning, Wednesday morning. When's Christmas? Tuesday. All right. We get up Tuesday morning, open gifts, right? I've got to remember this. Somebody's going to get up Tuesday morning. And they're going to walk downstairs, and they're going to see some things. And I'm going to tell you what. These kids, Brother Harvey, I've seen them. They're going to shout, scream, holler, carry on. Because, listen, they've been asking for this. And some of them even been praying for it. And they're going to shout, scream, holler, run through the house, have themselves a time. They're going to kick and scream. Y'all going to video and put it on Facebook. They're going to laugh and have a good time. I'm going to say, man, they love that. Amen. What an exciting. And look, I don't blame you. If I get something like that, I'm going to be excited too. I still get excited over gifts even though we don't give gifts. If I get one every now and then, I get a little excited. I ain't used to them, but I like them. Amen? But then there's some going to get up and be like a lot of Christians. Yeah. Did you get a gift? Yeah, I got it. You didn't like it? Oh, it was all right. You don't tell anybody about it? No. You ladies get that big diamond ring come Tuesday morning. It's going to be all over Facebook. They won't be able to see you or your finger, but they'll see the diamond on there. It'll carry up the whole page. Y'all will get a close-up. You men? Huh. You men, listen to me. You let a brand new truck be up in the driveway out there with a big red bow on it on Christmas morning. Don't think I won't take a picture up and tell somebody. Jane said, I don't like to do that. I don't care. It's mine, amen? I'm going to go tell somebody, amen? It's nice. But yet and still, the greatest and most perfect gift that's ever been given to us. A lot of times we're silent about it. He revealed them to the wise men. He revealed them to the shepherd. He revealed them to John the Baptist. He's revealed them to me. Has he revealed them to you? If he has, let's adore him. Let's sing it. Let's sing that first verse of O Come All Ye Faithful. Let's all stand today. The altar's wide open today. The altar's wide open. Listen,
Can you adore him today?
I don't know if y'all understood me today or not. We're talking about worshiping a holy God. And out of all you can adore this year around this season, how much you going to adore him? How much you going to let him know? We're going to be willing to fall out at his feet. Say, God, we adore you. Well, Brother Mike, he knows that, does he? You said the same thing about your wife, and a lot of them don't know that either. But you ain't told them lately. You ain't adored them. I know it's getting touchy right there. Amen. You love him today? Has it been revealed to you? Can you look down from the portals of glory today and say, that's my Savior. That's my Lord. That's my Master. That's my Redeemer. I'm going to sing praises unto him. This is the last verse. Last verse. They're going to sing this last verse today. You still got time to worship him this morning while they're singing.
All hail, Lord, we greet thee, born this happy morning. O Jesus, forevermore be thy name adored. Word of the Father, now in flesh appearing. Oh, come let us adore him. Oh, come let us adore him. Oh, come let us adore him, Christ the
He is the reason for the season. He is the most perfect gift. Listen, if we don't get anything at all for the Christmas holidays, make sure you have him. Make sure you have him. Let's go to the Lord in prayer today. We'll be dismissed. There'll be no service here tonight. We'll be here from 5:30. Get the doors built from 5:30 to 7. There'll be some around here praying. And we're going to be praying for our church and praying for our people and praying for a lot of the sick tonight. A lot of folks are going through some very trying time. There's some families in this church right now that's going through very trying time that can't even tell you about it. It's tough. But there is a Savior that loves us. And there's a Redeemer that's redeemed us, that we could have life and have life more eternal. And I pray that you know that life today. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. We're going to be dismissed. Brother Chris King, if you would, sir, how about dismiss us today?